So good afternoon, everyone. Welcome back to the workshop on blockchain and smart technology. So in the morning session, we already discussed some basic concepts of Ethereum blockchain. So now we are going to the first demo of this workshop. It's taken by Mr. Rohit. Mr. Rohit is assistant professor in BMS College, Bangalore. He is also a PhD student in Department of Computer Science and Engineering, NIT Trichy. Sir, you may please proceed with the demo session.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much. Yeah. Good afternoon, participants. I welcome you all for the demo session of this Ethereum smart contract. Okay. So first and foremost, so here, as anyone do trading in Ethereum? So let us have this session as interactive session. So I already given the software details that you need to download. I hope that participants have already downloaded, or if not, I'll give the instructions to download. So you should have some good internet speed with the desktop or laptop, right? So until unless you work along with me, right, you will not get the feel of executing the smart contract and how it is stored in the blockchain. Is that fine with the participants? So let us have some interactive session. So this is not a theoretical session. Okay, so I'll be giving some instructions you have to follow. If you have any queries regarding that, right, you have to post the queries here, right, so that everyone should follow the instruction. Yes, I'll share the link, right? Okay, I have posted the two links. One is Ganesh blockchain that you need to download to your local system. Other one is MetaMask. MetaMask is no issues. It's just a browser extension. You can directly add to that your extension. Okay, so coming back to this practical session, Ethereum blockchain. As you know that blockchain is a technology which is the very pretty famous after Bitcoin has evolved in 2008. Okay, Bitcoin uses blockchain technology, right? So in around 2013, right, Ethereum started using this blockchain technology. Okay, and Ethereum also allows you to use smart contracts. Smart contracts were also developed earlier, but they did not have a suitable platform to deploy. So after the Bitcoin has been deployed, right? So wherein Bitcoin uses blockchain technology, now Ethereum has came into existence so that it is able to use the blockchain technology, and Ethereum was already using the smart contracts. Okay, so with differentiation into permission blockchain and permissionless blockchain, I think in the morning session Kunwar sir has given you detailed discussion about what is permission blockchain and permissionless blockchain. Okay, so Bitcoin is a permission blockchain or permissionless blockchain, or public blockchain or private blockchain. Both are almost, the names are same. Public blockchain means like Bitcoin, everyone can be participant of that blockchain. Private blockchain means it is limited to consortium or an organization. Okay, wherein only known people can be added to that particular blockchain. So Ethereum is mainly a public blockchain, but you can also use that Ethereum as a private blockchain also. The pure private blockchain is Hyperledger, which will be discussed in the tomorrow session, right? Now, coming back to the Ethereum blockchain, can anyone tell me what is an address in Ethereum blockchain? Any student, any participant? You say that contract address, right? What is that contract address, and how many types of contract address exist here? Any answers? Two types. Okay, fine, good. Yes. Okay. So which are those two types? externally owned contract, yes. Then the other one is, yes, one is externally owned contact address, the other one is yes, which is the other one? Okay, fine, fine. Externally owned, yes, any answers? Yes, contract address, yes, smart contract address, right? Now, we are going to see that what is that externally owned account or contract address and what is the contract account or contract address, right? So here, mainly now, in the entire this practical session, I'll be discussing about three names, that is Remix, MetaMask, Ganache. Because this is mainly a practical session, okay? So I'll be starting from downloading the, using of this different platform, one platform to how exactly you can write the smart contract code. Okay, next other platform which acts like a platform which authorizes the authenticates the contracts, then a local blockchain, right? So for this, for writing the smart contract, we'll be using remix.ethereum.org. 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 This is a browser platform wherein we use this to code. Okay, just open this browser and type remix.ethereum.org. Let me share the screen. Okay, I hope my screen is visible to everyone.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay, fine. Now, just open the browser and type remix.ethereum.org. Okay, you'll be getting a platform like this. Probably like this. Okay, so we'll go hand in hand. Right, I request the participants to also work along with me. If you have any queries, right, you can post that. I'll follow up your queries. Is that fine? Right? If you have any queries, you just post in the chat box. I'll go to that queries. Is that fine, participants? Okay. remix.ethereum.org. This, we use this as a platform to code the smart contract. Okay. Next is MetaMask. MetaMask is a browser extension. If you just www.metamask.io. If you just open this metamask.io, right? So here you'll get that. It will ask you to download. So you can download as a browser extension. See here, you have a download button here. You can download this as a browser extension. Okay, I have already downloaded this and added to my Chrome as a browser extension. So you can see here, you can see my cursor here, right? So I have already added this as a browser extension. Can you able to do that, right? Okay, fine. Next is Ganache. So I've already pasted that. In the chat box, you can open that or you can download that using the website www.trufflesuit.com/Ganache. Okay, there was a dot in that URL, that's why it is not able to open. Okay, so once you click on this trufflesoup.com/Ganesh, right? So you get a web page like this, Ganesh one click blockchain, and you can download for Windows. Okay, click on this, download for Windows, and download that, and you can, once it is downloaded, double click on this. Okay, so I've already downloaded that particular website. I mean, the Ganesh blockchain, right? It is already in my device. What is this Ganesh is? Ganesh acts like a local blockchain. That means whatever you perform, whatever the smart contract that you execute on this platform, it will be stored in the Ganesh blockchain, Ethereum blockchain. Getting here? Clear about these three parameters, these three platforms? Ethereum, remix.ethereum.org, MetaMask, and Ganesh blockchain. Is this clear? Any doubts here, participants?
Ganesh is showing that the file, look for the app, is asking.
No, you open this trufflesoup.com/Ganesh.
Yeah, I opened it, download for Windows. And then okay. I downloaded it, and yes. Then I re-clicked for installation. It is asking that the XML file does not appear to have any style information associated with it.
What is the operating system that you are using, ma?
That is Windows 10.
Windows 10. I think it should work. You should have that a prerequisite of what do you call that? How about others? How about others, participants?
We are in the process of downloading. It's under process. So we are installing it, sir.
Yes. Once you download, just double click on that. You install that, right? It's a just very simple one. Okay, probably for you, madam, I think it is asking some prerequisite.
Remix and Ganesh are the same?
No, different, sir. Remix is a platform where you use that to type the smart contract. But Ganesh is a local blockchain.
In the Remix, what we must do?
You just open that remix.ethereum.org, sir.
Remix.ethereum.org. Ethereum.
You can see that. You can see my screen, sir.
Okay.
Remix.ethereum.org, right? If you just open that, then you get a platform like this, wherein we use this platform to code smart contracts. Any queries?
Sir is asking, look for a...
Yes, madam?
Looking for an app. So which app shall I choose then?
No app, no, ma'am. You have downloaded that Windows, Ganesh for Windows, right?
Yes, sir.
You have downloaded that Ganesh for Windows.
I downloaded that only.
It is nearly 187 MB.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, is it just
twice? In fact, it is actually I downloaded last month also, so it is there, but still again it's not running.
Okay, if it is already there, then you can just open that.
Yeah, that is also not opening. The same error is coming.
See, madam, like this app will be available once if it is downloaded. You can see my screen, madam?
Yes, sir, I can see.
Right? So once it is, once you install that Ganesh, right, like this, you get the app. I mean, you just double click on that. How about other participants? Still downloading, because even I have also started downloading, right? It is almost 180 MB is downloaded for me. No problem. Let us wait. I will go with all the participants. Right at the end of the session, right, you should know how to execute the simple smart contract, because we are all the faculties. Once we are aware of executing this, then we have plenty of projects, right, wherein that can be given to our students. See, madam, once it is downloaded, right, you get a like this. Can you see my screen, madam?
Yes, sir. I could see, but I'm
just open this, because I in my screen it's already there.
I'm trying to do it.
Yeah. How about other participants? Any queries? You're able to download. Open that. Yes, Shukumar, sir. Yes, sir.
We could open and it is asking quick start Ethereum.
Yes, 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 yes. That is perfect, sir. It is perfect. Let me also open. It takes time. I'm also opening that. Okay, once you have completed the download, right, double click on that. It is taking time, even though I have downloaded it long back, it's taking time for me to open that.
Hey, Kicha.
See, once you open that, you'll get a screen like this. Are you able to get this screen?
Yes, the screen has come.
Yes, that is perfect, sir, then. Okay, anybody else waiting? Right? Shall we go ahead? How about madam? One madam. Done, right?
No, sir, I'm just downloading it from this GitHub. So it's, I think it would done. GitHub,
okay,
it will
fine, ma'am. I'll just go ahead with this. If you have any queries, you can contact, ask me.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Now, this is a platform. This Ganesh is a local blockchain to your system. Right? Now, what is the smart contract? Smart contracts acts like a digital contracts. Right? Once, if any user, right, execute the smart contract, then these smart contracts are stored in the blockchain. I mean, Ethereum blockchain, right? Now, what is that Ethereum blockchain that you are using here? This is what Ganesh. Ganesh acts like a Ethereum blockchain for a standalone system. Getting here? Is this clear? Participants?
Yes, it is clear.
Okay, now once you open this, then you can choose quick start Ethereum and you have a new workspace Ethereum. New workspace Ethereum is way easy. You need to open that if you are using your own parameters. Okay, as of now, I'll use only quick start Ethereum. I'll click on this quick start Ethereum, right? And a screen will open like this. You can also click on that quick start Ethereum.
Yes, it is done.
Okay, probably your internet speed is more than my internet speed, sir. Okay, we'll wait for that. Okay, I hope this screen is visible to everyone.
Yes.
Right, so once you open this Ganesh Ethereum blockchain, automatically by default, Ganesh blockchain will provide you 10 addresses, wherein each address is having 100 ether. What is ether? What is an ether?
Cryptocurrency.
Ether is a cryptocurrency. Ethereum, see, Bitcoin, right? BTC, it stands as BTC, is a cryptocurrency for Bitcoin, whereas ETH, Ether, is a cryptocurrency for Ethereum.
So this has come after quick start to Ethereum. I'm writing the steps since I would leave.
Yes, yes. You can click on the quick start Ethereum. Once you click on that, then automatically you get a
the screen
page like this. Yes.
Okay.
Right. By default, 10 Ethereum address will be allocated for you, wherein each address is having 100 Ether. Okay. So yes. As I told that ETH is a cryptocurrency, right? Like rupee, dollar, ETH, BTC for Bitcoin, like this. Can you name any other cryptocurrencies?
Cardano, Chainlink, Polkadot.
Yes, yes, Cardano, Binance, Ripple.
Ripple, yes, BNB.
Okay.
Yes.
So like this, there are n number of cryptocurrencies available throughout the world. Okay. So do you know what is the current price of that Ethereum?
I guess $1,800.
Current price of Ethereum is almost 1,35,000.
In rupees.
Okay. In rupees. Yes, yes, yes.
In dollars.
Yes, 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 yes. Because now after I started with the research in this field, I have started trading in cryptocurrency. Right. Currently, I have some amount of Bitcoin, Ethereum, and Dogecoin also. Okay. So that is why I get the live Ethereum prices. Right. Now coming back to this. So once you open this quick start Ethereum blockchain, by default you get this. Right. Now let us go in detail about this. See accounts. So as the accounts is selected, you can see 10 accounts are there, wherein each account is having 100 Ether. Then transaction account is 0. And for every address, you have index 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, like this, till 10 or 9, 0 to 9. Then you have a key also. Show keys. See, account address is there and the private key is there. So for God's sake, don't show this private key to anyone. If at all, if you are user of a cryptocurrency, this is a private key. This should not be known to anyone. Right. So these are the parameters that are available here. Next, I have clicked on blocks.
Sir, who addresses are those, sir?
Pardon?
Oh, 10 addresses were there. These are just random addresses or what? Local addresses?
Dummy, sir. These are all dummy addresses.
Dummy addresses, right?
Yes, sir. Yes. Perfect. Dummy address and Ether is also dummy, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Right, like I told you that one Ether cost around 1,35,000, right? Just imagine 100 into 10, 1,00,000 Ether you are having here. Then what is the imagine of real time Ether? So these are all dummy Ethers. In real time, if you want to have one Ether, so yeah, according to our Indian rupees, it costs 1,35,000.
Yes.
Right. Next. So okay. Now blocks, I have selected, click on this blocks. You can see block zero mined on 26/6/2001, 1450, that is 250. And gas used is zero, no transaction as of now. What do you call this block zero?
Genesis block.
Yes, Genesis block. So it is the responsibility of the network who creates that blockchain to create the Genesis block, that is first block. Later on, you can go on adding to the Genesis block. So that will create a blockchain, right? So as of now, you don't have any other blocks except this Genesis block. Next, I'll click on this transactions. As of now, no transactions. As of now, no contracts, no events, only logs. Logs giving that what time I have started this Ganesh. All this information will be available in the log. Okay, then update available. Let us not this. Next, current block is zero. Gas price. What is this gas price? What is this gas? Why do you require this?
Transaction cost.
transaction fees.
Fees, yes.
Right? So all the smart contracts that you execute, if it is executed as a transaction, it incurs a transaction fees, and that is in terms of gas. Okay, so gas price is given here, gas limit is also given here. So it is the responsibility of the smart contract developer to specify the gas limit, indicating that until that gas is exhausted, right, your smart contract can be executed as a transaction. So once that gas limit is exhausted, then you cannot execute that smart contract, right? So that is the reason that the gas limit is also available. Then hard forker, right, is there. Network ID 5777, RPC server. If you want to connect to remote server, then this is what the address, 127.0.0.1.8545, which is a loopback address with the port number 8545. And here, as it is a local blockchain, so mining is taken care by automatically. So there is no particular mining algorithm that is specified automatically, because this acts like a simulator, right? So automatic mining will be happening, and workspace is quick start, right? This is what save switch are like. Next, then you have a settings here. So here you can name this project, then you can change this host name, port number, network ID, right? Then accounts and keys. As I told you that you have a default is 100 ether, then total accounts is 10. You can modify this. If you want, you can specify the 1000 ether. If you want, you can create 50 accounts, right? By specifying all these parameters, see, gas limit is specified here, gas price is specified. Okay, you can change all these parameters, then you can update and you can restart. As of now, I'm not going to change. So let all this be a default parameters. Is this clear about this, Ganesh? Any doubts here?
No doubt, sir.
No doubt. Fine. Okay. Let us come back to this other part of this. Okay. Now I'll come back to the remix.ethereum.org. You can switch on to the remix.ethereum.org. Now I told you that this is a platform to code your smart contracts, right? So here on the left side, right, you can see home button, home. Then below that, you can see file explorers, then Solidity compiler, then deploy and run transactions, right? So below all these things, I'll not be using any other things, right? So I'll click on this home. It is already available. Next, under this home, I'll be selecting the Solidity. You can see here Solidity. Click on that, select the Solidity. Right? Next here, under file, now I'll click on this file explorers. You can also parallelly do along with me, file explorers. So there are some already available contracts are there. Okay, so if you click on that contract, see owner.sol, ballot.sol, storage.sol. Okay, so already default smart contracts are available here. Now if you want to create your own smart contract, then you can see the button here, create new file. Is this visible,
sir? When we put Solidity, the compiler is coming, language is coming, and no contract.
Okay, sir. Now again, select file explorer, sir. Select file explorers.
File explorers.
Yes. Click on the file explorers. Yes, sir.
File explorer is available in the.
Yeah, below that, right? You can see that workspaces.
We have file, new file, open file, connect.
Create new file. Click on the create new file.
Okay.
Then it is asking to provide the name. You can give any name.
Okay.
1.sol. So after giving that 1.sol, right, editor will be open like this. Is this open for you?
One second, I'm trying. When I put new file, nothing is opening.
No, sir, you create new file. See, once you create.
Sir, can you repeat once again? Sure, can you repeat once again for creating the file?
Yes, sir. Sir, click on this file explorers. You get a window like this. There you have a create new file. Right. Click on that. Then here automatically it is asking you to provide the name of that file.
Sir, file explorer from where? Oh, sorry, I didn't follow it up.
Below that file explorer, create new file.
Where do you get file explorer, sir?
In the left side below home. You can see my cursor here.
File explorer, yes, it has come. Okay.
Okay. Now below that, create new file.
Okay, contracts, we can create new file. Okay,
no, new file. You follow my cursor, sir.
Okay.
Create it's new fine. File.
Okay.
Then it is asking you to provide the file name.
Yes.
Give some suitable name with .sol as extension, indicating that it is a solidity file.
.sol. Okay.
Then enter. Automatically, a screen editor will be opened for you. Is this fine?
Yes, fine.
Done. Everyone done? Okay. Now, this is a platform wherein you can type the.
Sir, we have typed the name. After that, what we must type?
Just enter. Name enter. Dot? SOL. Solidity. SOL.
Sir?
Dot solidity.
Dot SOL. You can see my yes. name here. Oh, yes. Test1.sol. Test.sol. First.sol. 1.sol.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, yeah.
Actually, I am first clicked on the contracts, then I clicked on create new file.
Okay.
And then it showed me a new file below ballot.sol, a blank, and where we have to type the name.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Perfect. Perfect.
I am clicking on it and I'm typing, but nothing is being typed on. I don't know what is happening.
See, sir. No, see, I am clicking on create new file.
Yeah.
Okay. Now it is open now.
Yes. Yes. This is the same. Yes.
See, ELEVEN.SOL.
It is not getting typed. This box is coming, but the nothing is getting typed.
You just select that, sir. You select that.
Simply type, sir. Simply type. Don't wait and don't think for the cursor. Simply if you are typing.
I don't know what is happening. Actually, I am on a Mac. There may be something different is happening here. But
okay, you are on Mac device. Huh? But still,
but the interface is same and this is appearing similarly.
With, yeah, yeah.
I'm unable to.
Probably insert button has clicked on your keyboard.
Just a second, sir. No, sir, I am not able to do that. Okay, you continue, sir. I'll
okay,
see.
Okay, it. Fine, sir.
No problems.
Okay. Now, so I think everyone are with me till here. Now you get a platform like this. Now you need to code. Right? So I'll just show you the simple smart contract. Okay. So I'll just provide this code for you all through the chat box. You can copy paste,
sir. Better in the WhatsApp group, sir. We are using another device for. We are using the two device.
Okay.
Better give it in the chat in the WhatsApp group. Then only we can copy and paste.
Okay, I don't know that WhatsApp group now.
So the host can help.
Yeah.
Why it is not getting typed down?
I have pasted that in the chat box. Madam,
you want to put it in WhatsApp group, sir?
Yeah, he's requesting
I have put it in the WhatsApp
I'm
group.
copying it, no problem.
Okay.
New
I have
file.
put it in, sir.
Okay.
What
Fine.
is it? How to type?
Done? Arif,
yes,
you can type, sir. It's just not even 1 minute it will take.
Admin has to put, only admin can operate in WhatsApp.
Only admin can operate, sir.
Okay.
But it has been copied. It has come in WhatsApp. Please check.
Check, sir.
Yes, it has come in WhatsApp.
Okay. So I'll just provide you the documentation which allows you to go through that sorry in detail. I'll paste that in the chat box. Okay. So we'll go to this first smart contract. Is everyone ready?
Not able to type. What is happening?
Okay, others?
Sir?
Yes, sir.
One question.
Yes, sir.
Sir, is it that the browser, I'm using Safari, so maybe Safari is causing some problem, or I should use Chrome?
Maybe, sir. I'm not
asking for Chrome, sir.
It is asking for Chrome.
Chrome, yes.
Okay, I'll switch then.
Sir, this documentation we have to read later, okay?
Am I audible, sir?
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Okay, fine. Okay, now this is the first smart contract. Pragma solidity greater than or equal to 0.4.16 lesser than 0.8.0. So this should be the first line in your smart contract. Pragma is like a indirect directive, like hash include thing, right? So indicating that the below are the solidity code, and this should be compiled in the compiler version greater than or equal to 0.4.16 or lesser than 0.8.0. Is this clear? This should be the first line in all the smart contracts, right? Next, contract name, contract simple storage, right? So if you are all familiar with C++ or Java, right? So that is a prerequisite to understand the Solidity programming language, right? So Solidity programming language is almost same as the C++ or Java. So contract simple storage is the name, open flower bracket, unsigned integer stored data is the variable name. Then function set is a function, right? So which you are using the value to set to that variable stored data. In the same way, get is a function which you use to fetch that value from the variable. Getting here?
Sir, before contract, we need a one line space.
Not required, sir.
But better for readability, right?
That's it. Okay. Is this simple smart contract understood by everyone?
Sir, repeat.
Okay. See, this is a simple smart contract wherein you are declaring a variable and you assign the value to that variable, and the value will be stored in that variable. Then you try to fetch that value from that variable. So to function this, you are making use of set and get functions in Solidity. Is this fine?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Right? So this is a simple smart contract. Okay, is this fine now? Now, let us start comparing and deploying this in the blockchain.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Is that fine? Okay. Now, how to compile this? Now, on the left side, below this file explorer, you can see Solidity compiler. Can anyone see this, everyone? Select, click on that, you get a compiler version here. Is everyone with me?
Okay. Yes.
Below this file explorer, there is a Solidity compiler. Click on that. Yes, yes, yes. Perfect, perfect.
0.84.
Yes, sir.
Sir, 0.84 is there, sir. Compiler.
0.84.
4+.
What is the version of the of your compiler, sir? 0.4.
0.4 plus
coming C7E47. That's fine, sir. So, see, just a minute, sir. See, I have given that Pragma Solidity greater than or equal to 0.4.16, lesser than 0.8.0. So, any compiler in this range should work.
This is a higher version, sir. 0.84.
No, no, no. Then you have to change that.
Okay, okay.
So, click on this. And select any other compiler version.
Okay, okay, okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Yeah. It should be lesser than 0.8.0.
Okay, okay. 0.76 is there.
Yeah. Okay. So compiler version, then language is Solidity. Okay. Then EVM version. What is this EVM? Any answers? Ethereum virtual machine. Like how
virtual job? Machine, sir.
Pardon?
Ethereum virtual machine.
Sir. Yeah, Ethereum virtual machine. Yes, sir.
Compiler default only we got it.
Yeah, yeah, that's fine. Fine, fine, fine.
Actually, this EVM machine, it's converting the whatever we are writing a contract or something that is getting converted into just like a compiler. It's working here. In
yes, it see whatever the program that you have, right? Mm-hmm. This is compiled and converted to bytecode.
Bytecode.
I'll show you that bytecode here. I'll show you that now, right? So EVM version is a compiler default. Then auto compile is already selected. Then you get a compile first.sol. What are the name that you have got? You get like this. Then contract, simple storage, first.sol, publish on swarm, publish on IPFS, compilation detail, then ABI and bytecode. All these things are visible for you all?
No, sir. No, no.
Scroll down, sir.
Compile, yes, sir.
This will come. Okay, now, while we click the compile, we are getting it.
Yes.
No contract compiled yet. It is coming.
Wait.
Now I'll compile.
I'll click on this compile first.sol. Right? Okay. It is compiled. Okay. And now a bytecode is available. I'll just copy and paste this bytecode in the chat box. Can you see this?
Yes.
Right? So these are also called. So this is what the bytecode of this smart contract. Ethereum.
Where do you got this from?
A byte, you have a bytecode, right? At below.
Yeah. Okay, just click on. We'll click on it. We'll get it.
Yeah, just copy that. Yeah, right, yeah, you'll get this. Okay, now Ethereum supports nearly 150 opcodes like swap 1, div, push 4, and jump instruction like this. Ethereum nearly supports 150 opcodes, and all these opcodes are available in Ethereum base paper. Is this clear, sir? Right? Next, what are the smart contracts that you have here? You can publish this in on IPFS. What is an IPFS?
Interplanetary.
Interplanetary file system.
File system.
Right. So when you are storing larger data in the blockchain, especially when you are using Ethereum blockchain, right? So it consumes more gas. To overcome that, what IPFS concept is there is, so we store all the data in the IPFS, and in turn IPFS will return an hash value, right? You can take that hash value and you can store that hash value in the smart contract. So our data size may be in terms of GB, but hash value size may be in terms of KB. So that is what the advantage that you gain when you store the larger data in IPFS. Getting here? Is it clear, sir, for everyone?
Second, please.
Sir, repeat, sir.
Okay. Interplanetary file system is a technology which is used to store data from the users, right? And in turn, it will give you the hash value, which indicating the address of the data that it is storing. Suppose now, if
hash value address, hash value address,
hash value, which is acting like an address of your data. Getting, sir?
Yes. Okay.
Okay.
Hash value is store. Sir, instead of data, it give you hash value.
The IPFS stores the data.
Okay.
For that, it will return the hash address.
For the data.
For the data. Now, anyone having that hash address can get back the data.
Okay. Thank you.
That is what the advantage when you use IPFS.
Okay.
So you can publish this contract to store in IPFS also. Right. Next. Now the program is successfully compiled. Now let us deploy this. Now below that Solidity compiler, you have a button like deploy and run transaction. Just click on that. And you get a window like this. Environment at account. Gas limit, value, contract, deploy, at address, all these things. It is clear? Please don't go ahead of me. Yeah, deploy and run transaction. Just click on that. You get a window like this. Is everyone with me?
Sir,
yes.
When environment that we have selected is injected Web3.
Wait, but... I'll come. Wait, ma'am. Are you getting this window?
Yes, sir. I'm getting this window.
Is everyone getting this window right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, in this environment, you have JavaScript virtual machine, that is Berlin, JavaScript virtual machine, London, injected Web3 and Web3 provider. So it provides three different types of environment for your smart contract. What is JavaScript virtual machine is, it is when you select that environment, what are the smart contract that you are executing here, right? So it will virtually create a blockchain and store your smart contract virtually. So you require this environment when you doesn't have Ganesh Ethereum blockchain. Is this clear?
When you don't have
JavaScript VM is nothing but when your smart contracts are executed, virtually it creates a blockchain for your smart contract and that is stored. But that's what the virtually, that's what you won't get the feel where that exactly the smart contract is stored.
Okay.
So this environment is suitable when you don't have Ganesh blockchain.
Okay.
Is this getting, sir?
Okay, sir.
Right. So now next you have injected Web3. So execution environment has been provided by MetaMask. So when you click on this injected Web3, usually what happens? See, if I deploy this, I'll not get the feel that my smart contract is stored in the blockchain. I'll not select this. Right. So for that purpose, right, I'll select injected Web3. So once I select that injected Web3, this remix.ethereum platform will be automatically connected to MetaMask. MetaMask browser extension. Now, how many have not added the MetaMask browser extension? Is anyone added that to, as your browser extension?
Yes, I have added, sir.
Yes, I have added.
Yes, sir.
If you have added, you can see a dog symbol like this here. You can see my cursor?
Yes, sir.
Right? So,
sir,
yes, sir.
Sir, one second, sir. One second.
Yes, sir. So, when you select this environment of injected Web3, automatically, automatically your remix.ethereum will be connected to MetaMask.
Yeah.
MetaMask, sir, we have downloaded, but it is not shown in the.
It is a plugin. Remix. It's a browser extension.
Add to Chrome.
Add to Chrome. Add to Chrome. Yes.
Sir, I've forgotten my password.
Then you cannot recover.
No, I cannot recover. It is asking for some phrase and all. And
While you created that, right, it will give you some 12 phrases. Seed phrases.
Sir, one said where we can find the extension, sir?
See here, you can see my cursor, sir, here.
No, sir, I could not see.
Below the
right side corner, box is there. Okay, but
top,
that we have to add in our browser, sir.
Yes, add edge to Chrome. Browser.
It cannot come in Edge.
Just check, sir, whether it is available for Edge or
Edge supports Chromium, I guess, extensions.
So once you add to Chrome, automatically, right? So it will ask you to create an account name. It will ask you to provide the password. Then it will give you seed phrase.
Sir, already I have this MetaMask seed phrase, so I can import that wallet, or I should go for
definitely. I'll show you, sir. I'll show you. You can import.
Okay, I already have created earlier.
Fine. I hope everyone are up to this level. Is there any doubts here?
Okay, no problem, sir.
Okay. Fine.
It has to go to. It is not coming in Edge. It is coming in Chrome. Okay, we have to Okay, we have to go to Chrome again. So that's in Edge.
Chrome and Brave are supported. I have tried Brave browser also.
Sir, here we must import the wallet or create a wallet, sir.
Create a wallet.
Come. Get started. Okay.
So I must agree.
Yeah.
Create a wallet. Okay.
Create a wallet. It will ask you to provide some password and 12 seed phrase. It will provide you. You have to perform all those things. Then you should not forget that 12 seed phrase.
Password can be with any specification, sir, or
nothing, capital. Nothing like that. But you should not forget that password and this 12 seed phrase.
12 speed base, you can neglect, sir.
Yeah, if you want, you can neglect. If you are confident that you will not forget your password, you can neglect.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Because, sir, these things are required if you are dealing with the real ethers.
Yeah.
Assume that now your wallet has some 100 ethers in real time. Okay. Just imagine what's the value of that. So, all those wallet. Things. Yeah. Is that fine with everyone?
Yeah, all done.
Sir, one second, wait, sir. Please, sir, wait.
Yeah.
Doing it.
Secret backup phrase, is that to be done?
We can download here. Download MetaMask today or add to Chrome, you get. See, sir, once you click on this download, Chrome, iOS, Android, it is asking. I've selected install MetaMask for Chrome.
Okay, good.
Okay. For Chrome, Firefox, Brave, Edge, it is functioning.
Okay.
Done, sir. Everyone done?
We have gone up to secret backup phrase. We can go ahead?
Yes, you can go ahead.
Sir, I have forgotten my phrase. I need to reinstall.
Better man, delete that and you can go once again.
Sir, once I have given the password.
Yes, sir.
That is asking me.
It is asking?
Next like that.
Yeah, you click on that.
Sir, I created that account and the account I can see 088. So is that correct?
Yes, correct, sir.
That is real value of Ethereum which you have.
MetaMask provides 0 Ether.
Okay. Okay, sir.
That is correct. Perfect.
We can buy and deposit cryptocurrency here, actually. Yeah, yeah. MetaMask.
You can see here, sir. You can see here account 1 0 Ethereum, account 2 0 Ethereum.
Yeah,
in this confirm your secret backup phrase, how many phrase you have to select, sir? Any condition is there?
No, you have to consider all the phrases. It will ask one by one because it is a meaningful sentence. I think so.
Okay.
Done till here?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, this MetaMask, it provides you different networks. Ethereum main network, Ropston test network, Cowan, RinkBuy, then localhost 8545 and custom RPC. Select localhost 8545. Select localhost 8545. See, sir.
How we get this page, sir?
See. You can see here, local here. Click on this, then you get different networks.
Yes, sir.
Select localhost 8545.
Okay.
Now you'll be connected to localhost 8545. That is?
Something went wrong.
Is it fine?
It's scrolling, sir.
So for me, it is saying, oops, something went wrong.
Yeah, me too.
Just again, try, sir. Try.
Repeat the same, sir.
Repeat.
Sir, please repeat this.
Okay. So you click on this, select.
Okay.
Then here you can get here. So there are different types of networks. Select localhost 8545.
Sir, before coming to this page, we had to deploy that contract before clicking.
Not required.
Okay, but it is showing that something went wrong.
I'll show you. Wait.
Connecting to localhost.
8545.
Yes, 8545.
Not getting
okay. It is coming switch to different network.
Yeah, switch networks or something went wrong.
Yeah.
You try doing that, sir. You will get it.
So we can do with Ropston also.
Sir,
yes, sir.
Sir, I have one doubt. So is this IP address and port number belongs to RPC server that is part of Ganache?
Yes, sir.
So see, then there is a so in your case it is 8545, but in my case it is 7545. So that could be the reason.
Yeah, then you can change, sir.
Yeah, so I will try after changing it then.
Yeah. So you see, because you'll get localhost, right? Localhost. And it will provide you the address, port number.
Right, sir.
Okay. Now, what is this MetaMask and why do you require this? Now, MetaMask acts like a wallet, right? So whenever you send any transactions using this remix.ethereum, it will validate that smart contract. Only once you approve that, then the transaction is validated and that will be stored in the local Ethereum blockchain. Getting here? So purely MetaMask acts like a wallet for all your transactions. Is this clear? Right? Now, so all your MetaMask accounts have 0 ethers. So if it is having 0 ethers, you cannot do anything. So for that purpose, let us import the account from Ganesh. Is this clear?
Okay, is it on with me? It is not account one itself is not opening. So how could That is that, yeah, it is still asking connecting to host, try again.
You try, sir. You'll get that.
Okay, okay. Then only we can go to that import option.
Yes, yes. So once you click on this, then you get import account.
Okay.
You can select that import account, and it is asking the private key string here.
Okay.
Okay. Now come back to Ganesh. Come back to Ganesh. Right. Select the accounts. So in that you first account address, at the end you have a show keys. Is everyone with me?
One second.
Participants, can you able to follow me?
In Ganesh, we have to go to accounts.
Yes, accounts.
We are trying the MetaMask.
In MetaMask, still it is not connected, sir. It is still asking for try again.
How many have done that?
I hope nobody has told they have connected. Everybody is this.
Not getting connected so far.
Sir, I think the port and the IP combination needs something.
Okay, do one thing, sir. So here, under this.
Settings, sir.
RPC server is there, right?
Yes.
So there. See, port number 8545 is given for me. Just check what is the port number that is there for you.
It was 7545, but I changed and checked. Still, it was not.
It will work. It has to work, sir.
So even, sir, in my case also, I changed that 8545 and then restarted the Ganesha. But then still it is giving me the same error. It says, oops, something went wrong. Try again.
Something is, I don't know.
It could be, sir, related to our network.
Okay, sir, one thing. Now, is Ganesh is running in your device?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay.
Ganesh is having 7545.
To connect MetaMask, Ganesh should be running.
Yeah, it is running.
Then it should connect.
So if Ganesh is having 7545, here also we have
connected.
You should get localhost 7545.
Localhost automatically it is showing 8545. So you have to go to custom and change it.
Yeah, you can change that.
Yeah, sir, I changed that to 8545 and then I clicked on MetaMask and now it is connected.
Yeah, it requires refresh. That's it, sir.
Refresh that page of your browser also.
Yes.
You have put 7545, sir, or 8545?
8545.
How to refresh?
Sir, where the change the 8445?
Okay, in Ganesh, sir. So here.
Ganesh. Yes, let us show it, sir.
In Ganesh, okay. Settings, accounts, I guess. Yeah. No.
Ganesh.
Server.
Ganesh server
is closed.
Yeah.
Where is the settings, sir?
That is a gear icon at the top right corner in Ganesh.
Right side.
Settings icon.
Settings icon server.
After switch, I guess.
Yes,
yeah.
After switch, server is there. 7545. There we can give 8545.
Yes, there you
are. Yes.
That I did and it's working now. And then restarted.
After giving 8545, save and restart.
Yes.
Okay, I changed. Let me go and try. Connecting to local host 8545.
Show the settings, sir. Settings.
See here.
Settings. Right.
Yeah, then, server.
Okay. Server.
Yeah.
Support number.
Okay.
Yeah, change this. Yes.
Okay.
Then default is 8545, so I will not change. Right. Once you type that, then you restart.
Restart. Okay.
But it's still coming connecting to localhost 8545.
It takes time, ma'am. You just keep on refreshing that. Oh shit! I closed the Ganesh.
Blockchain, sir.
I guess you can select some other network first, then in MetaMask, then select localhost. It will get connected.
Okay, by that time, I'll just show you the JavaScript, JavaScript virtual machine execution only, meanwhile.
Yes.
Let others do that. I'll demonstrate this. Okay. Okay, fine. Now I'll select the environment as JavaScript virtual machine, right? And this virtual machine, it gives you 10 different address with each having 100 ether, right? Now let me deploy this. See here, you can see here, you have a deploy button at address and transaction recorded is equal to 0. Is this clear?
Please repeat, sir.
See here, once you select this deploy and run transactions and in okay. the environment, select JavaScript VM.
JavaScript VM.
Yes.
But previously we have selected another one, sir, another environment.
That's what, that is using MetaMask. Let others also come to that position.
I got connected with it.
It will connect, madam. It will connect. It will take time. Yeah. That's it.
Please, shall okay. I click connect now?
Where, ma'am?
Connect to account. It is getting connected to
wait,
account.
Wait, ma'am. We'll come back. We'll come back. I'll demonstrate first JavaScript VM, then I'll come back to injected Web3. Now everyone can see here deploy and at address, right? And below that transaction recorded is equal to 0.
Okay.
Can everyone see this window?
Yes, yes.
Okay. Now I'll click on this deploy. So my contract is already compiled and now I'm going to deploy this smart contract. So you can see the transaction recorded is equal to 1.
Okay.
Yeah.
That means this transaction is completed. Right? Now below this deployed contracts and you have a simple storage at. So once your contract is deployed, automatically it has got one address.
Yes, sir.
That is nothing but the contract address. I have pasted that in the chat box. Now this is what contract address for this contract. So I told you that smart contract in Ethereum, you have two types of contracts. One is externally owned contract address. Other one is contract address. So once after you deploy this contract, now it has created a contract address for your contract. Can everyone able to see this?
Sir, where you will get deploy
contracts
transaction address, sir?
See here, below this transaction recorded deployed contracts, you have a simple okay. storage.
Okay.
Simple storage at.
Yes, yes, yes.
Then at the end, you have a copy value.
Okay.
You can also copy and paste in the chat box.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you.
Sir, how the contract address is same for you and me as well?
Where?
I mean, at my end also, I see the same contract address.
It is a dummy, I guess. I don't know.
Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah.
Can anyone try? Yeah, for everyone, it is giving the same.
Yeah.
Dummy.
Dummy, okay. Sir, is it? It is a dummy, I guess. That's why it is.
Yes, 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 yes. All the addresses are, all the ethers are dummy here.
We all have the same. In our...
Yes, yes. Now, what is externally owned account?
Like, Binance and all.
See here, under this deploy and run transaction, you have an account, right? That is what you mean by externally owned account address. Now I'm going to paste this here. Check this address. And you can also do that.
Which one, sir?
See, under this deploy and run transactions, below that you have an account, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
And right side of that, you can copy value.
Okay.
So that this is what externally owned account address, okay. Nothing but wallet address. I think these are the same for everyone.
Yes, we can right? post and
now
see.
You got the difference between the two addresses.
One is a deployed contract address, one is account address.
Yes, yes. Is this clear? Now, your smart contract is deployed successfully, but you are not getting the feel of that contract as it is deployed in the blockchain, right? Right? Now, for that purpose,
yes.
Right, we will change the environment as injected Web3. So what happens when you change the environment as injected Web3? Can anyone tell? When you change this environment as injected Web3,
it gets connected to MetaMask.
See here. Can you see my screen?
Yes.
Once I change the environment injected Web3, automatically MetaMask is active and it is asking me to connect with MetaMask.
Okay, we will also try.
Do this. Can you able to get that?
Yeah, it says insufficient balance for gas and gas limit.
That is why don't deploy contract.
Oh, acha, okay.
Connect, just connect.
Sir, when we give environment to inject Web3, it is saying no injected Web3 provider founded. Make sure your provider is active and running.
Your MetaMask is active, sir.
MetaMask. I could get 0 Ether and account 1 is the name displayed.
Yeah.
Local post 855.
Or else, so, don't think, sir. Okay. Okay. How many are getting this screen?
It's
good number.
Okay.
Me.
Only one?
I couldn't get this connected with
MetaMask. How about others?
No, I couldn't get it, sir.
Sir, connected, sir.
Okay, good. Okay, click on next. Connect to account 1. It is saying, I'll just select the connect. So it is connecting. Now it is connected.
Yeah, it's getting connected.
So what's happening for others?
Once more, repeat it, sir. We have to go to the environment.
Environment, select injected Web3. Once you select that injected Web3, automatically MetaMask will be active and it will ask you to connect.
Even if it's not going to be active, it's going to come down in the task.
So now this Ethereum and MetaMask is connected now.
Yes,
it has connected to an account which has an address.
MetaMask is acting like a wallet for your smart contract now. Now we will try to import the Ganesh addresses because this MetaMask account is having 0 Ether. So no use. You cannot do that, right? Now, yes. Click on this MetaMask and on the right hand side, you have click on that, then you click on this import account. Now it is asking to paste your private key. Is everyone with me?
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes, fine. Now come back to Ganesh, right?
Okay.
In the first address. So at the last column, you have a show keys.
So click please on repeat that. After Ganesh, after you going means connecting to MetaMask, what do you have to do?
Come back to Ganesh.
Okay.
First select in the first address. In the last column, you have a show keys.
Okay.
Click on that. You get the account address and private key. Copy this private key. Control C, done.
Okay.
Now come back to MetaMask.
Paste it and import.
Import.
Just a minute. Import account. Yes, now paste this private key here and click on import.
100 ETC.
100 ETH is being shown, sir.
Yes, sir. Now everyone got 100 Ether. Value of 100.
I couldn't. I could get it is not connected, sir. So it is showing only 0 ETH.
Okay.
From our Remix Ethereum IDE, it is still telling no injected found. Make sure it is coming.
Okay. Fine. How about others?
What is the mistake we are doing?
I can see, sir, 100 ETH.
Right.
Okay.
Now
once we have to, we can go out of MetaMask and come inside.
Sir,
MetaMask, we can go out and come inside. There is no log off. A lock
yes,
is
yes,
the
yes,
word.
Yes, yes, yes.
Lock is the word, correct, sir, for going
out? No, it just, if you just come out, automatically it will be stored in the extension. Or else, yeah, no. You,
is there any logout function available?
Settings. Or else you can delete that.
Okay.
Is there anyone getting the screen? Is successfully able to connect?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah. Now, what we have to do is, we have to make this account as primary account. So that we can use this 100 Ether to execute all the smart contracts. Right? Account 2 is not connected to any sites. Let me connect.
Sir, other than Ganache, what other platforms we can use to do this private key?
Because Ganache is only platform available for simulation purpose. Other than this, you have a sim block.
Block
that means. That is a complete simulation platform. That means starting from the parameters, you have to code like NS2 and NS3.
Okay. Like for research purpose, we can use BlockSim.
Yeah, you can use this also. But if you want to measure the performance and all, you cannot do here.
BlockSim would be good one.
SimBlock.
SimBlock, okay.
Yeah.
Sir, where did you got this private key from?
Ganache. Then in the last corner column, you have show keys. Click on that, then you get a private key. Then copy that, then paste here. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now just check whether this account is made as a primary account in your MetaMask.
Okay.
Because you have two accounts. One is account 1 we having 0 Ether and account 2 having 100 Ether. Select yes. that. Select that. Select that and make that as a primary account so that you can have 100 Ether. You can use that.
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now we have set the platform now. Remix.ethereum is set, MetaMask is set, Ganache is set. Now what we have to do is we have to compile this Solidity smart contract code, right? And MetaMask will authenticate that and ask you to confirm that transaction. Once you confirm using MetaMask wallet, then automatically this transaction will be stored in Ganache blockchain. Shall we see that?
Yes, sir.
Now, see here, under this account, if you click on that, there is only, okay, I think this is still not connected. We'll connect this. Okay, now I have connected this. So automatically I've got 100 Ether in the remix.ethereum. Did you observe this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, right? Okay, fine. Now, injected Web3 is the environment. Account is the Ganache account that is already we have connected, right? Now, transaction recorded is equal to 0. Deploy or at address. What is this at address means? What do you mean by this? Participants? That means, if at all you want to deploy this contract to a particular contract address, you can do that also.
Okay, you can give the name, sir.
No, not name, address, sir. Contract address.
Okay.
Okay, now I'll deploy this. See here, transaction record is 1 and automatically MetaMask is active and it is asking me to confirm and it is charging gas fees. 0.002025, right? Now only if I confirm, then only this transaction is successfully, it will store in the blockchain. Shall I confirm now?
Yes.
So you are able to get this?
No.
Yes, sir. But the only thing is that the gas fees are different for me.
No problem, no problem, no problem.
Okay, sir.
Confirm.
Okay.
Yes, sir, confirm, sir.
Now, I'll show you this transaction here in the Ganesh.
Confirm.
Come back to transactions. Click on blocks. See here, block one is mined at 350. Gas usage is 101241 and one transaction is successful. Okay, if you select transactions, see here, transaction hash from address, created contract address, gas used. What is this from address? From address is nothing but the first address of this Ganesh, which we have imported to MetaMask, right?
Yes, sir.
So from that address, we have executed this transaction, and for the transaction, this contract address is created. Now, can anyone tell me what is your contract address? Participants?
1 minute.
Can anyone tell me?
0 into 354.
Four C's
986. Can you copy it, sir?
No, this one you don't have option. I think you have to select. But so
created. See,
what is the from address? What is the from address?
0 into 4B 4E 9827.
Yes, yes.
But now. 96 sir 393 sir,
that's fine sir, that's fine, everything is represented in that hexadecimal. Okay, so transaction hash
block is created, block also.
Yes, transaction is created, right? So everything is successful,
block is created.
Yes.
Now
are you getting the feel that your transaction is stored in the blockchain,
sir?
Specifying the from address, created contract address, and transaction hash.
Sorry for interrupting, sir. And yes, still sir. That till when we go to this remix Ethereum, where environment JavaScript is there, when we select inject Web3,
yes,
it is telling no injected Web3 provider found. But when I go to my this MetaMask, it is showing localhost 8545 account 10 ETH. So from
think, sir, here, now, what should in I this do? MetaMask, you try to import one account, sir.
I am putting import. Yes. There I have to. You told I have to create my private key, correct?
Import account.
Copy the private key.
Can you see this? Can you see my screen, sir?
Yes.
Import account, click on that. It is asking for private key.
Yes.
Come back to Ganesh.
Okay.
Account, select accounts. So there you have what? 10 different addresses. You can select any of these address. Okay. Now I'll select the second address.
Okay.
In the last column, you have show keys.
Show key. Okay.
Click on that. Then you get account address and private key. Copy this private key.
Okay.
Control C. Done. Come back to MetaMask.
Come back to MetaMask. Yes.
Paste then import, your import account. Paste here. Control V. Then import.
Yes, I have given import and it has gone inside and account 2 is created. But
with 100 Ethereum.
It is.
So that account is having 100 Ether.
But both the accounts are showing 0 Ethereum.
No, you should have 100 Ether, sir.
Now, because of my this remix is not environment is still not connected to.
No, sir. Actually, once you import that, right? Because when you are importing that, that account is having 100 Ethereum. So once you import that, you actually should get that 100 Ethereum.
It is not coming. It is showing account 1 0, account 2 also 0, imported.
Try once again, sir.
Where should I create new account or import account?
Import account.
I'm going to Ganesh. I'm taking the second key.
Okay.
I'm private key. I'm copying control.
So you should copy only private key.
Yes, I have connected private key, whatever you are showing. I'm going to MetaMask. And in MetaMask, it is select type private key, paste your private key string here. I'm pasting it.
Yes.
And then import.
Import.
Account 3, it is showing, but only 0 ETH. I don't know what mistake.
Ethereum. Okay, maybe probably.
100 Ethereum comes from Ganesh, sir.
Yes. Because, see, your account is imported from Ganesh to MetaMask. Okay. So when your account
Ganesh, it is showing 8545. That is also server number is correct.
Okay. Sir, in real time also, right, you can import the address from different exchanges. So whatever the address currency that it is having, same currency will also be imported. Because as I am doing that real-time trading, right? So I know that I have done that.
Okay. But only error what I am doing is in the deploy and run transaction, I am not able to connect to inject web. That is the reason for this or it is?
That is the reason, sir. Yes. No. That is the reason that I think you have to do it once again, sir, because probably your MetaMask and Remix is not connected.
That is not getting connected. For that, Remix and MetaMask are not connected.
Yeah.
Starting Ganesha.
Okay, anyway, sir, at the end of this, I'll give you the document, so wherein it will have some step-by-step procedure.
Okay.
You can go through that.
Okay.
Fine, right? Okay. Now, this is how a smart contract can be executed, and all those smart contracts will be stored in your local Ganesh blockchain. So now, till here, any doubts till here?
No, sir.
Let me come back here. Yes, participants. Theoretically, or let okay. Maybe anything. If you have any doubts, you can ask me here.
Sir, in the Ganesha, right? So when I expand the block one, I can see from address. So that from address, I can also see the same from address in the
MetaMask.
Yes.
Yes.
That means this is successful.
Yes, definitely. You can compare, sir. See, in the transactions, you have this from address, right? You can compare this from address, and in the Remix, it will be same.
Yeah, correct.
It should be same. Any doubts still here? Now you clear about what is externally owned account, what is contract address, right?
Sir, MetaMask, a contract deployment 0 ETH is there.
That is MetaMask account. Okay.
In MetaMask account, but only is in the account ETH is 99.9981 is there.
That means, see, you are already successfully executed one contract, sir. That is why from 100 Ether, some part of Ether is reduced.
Reducible gas, but only in the below, in activity below, contract deployment 0 ETH. Below that one, activity, it is mentioned contract deployment 0 ETH.
Where below activity?
Below, in the same MetaMask account.
MetaMask?
MetaMask.
Okay, just a minute, sir. Okay, tell me, sir, where?
In the contract deployment 0 ETH.
Okay, under activity,
Under activity, sir.
Maybe for that account, you are using the first primary account as MetaMask account.
Okay.
But still, when you click on this, right, you'll get different accounts, right, which wherein each account is having some ethers.
1 minute, sir. Sir, let us show it again, sir.
Okay, just a minute. I think I have stopped sharing. See, sir, when you click on this MetaMask.
Yes, sir.
See here, a primary account, account 4, it is showing 100 Ethereum, right?
Okay,
99 something, all right. Ah, yeah, yes, fine. Because you are successfully executed one transaction.
Okay, in the below, in the activity column.
That's fine.
Okay.
See, if you click here, you can get account 1, 0 ETH, account 2, 99, account 3, 100, account 4, 100.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Like this. It will give the details about all the accounts. So account 1 is nothing but MetaMask account. MetaMask does not provide you any Ethereum.
Okay, thank you.
Yes.
Thank you, sir.
Any doubts?
Sir, I could find out the error. In my Ganesha, it is showing 0 Ether only available. Actually, yearly it was showing 100 Ether. So that's why when I go to MetaMask, no money is getting transferred.
Restart, it happened to me also.
Close that, sir. Close that and open once again.
Close the Ganesha and now again reopening so that it will come.
Please do that. Because it will defaultly open with 10 addresses and each account is having 100 Ethers.
Yes, yearly you told that, but now once when I'm getting connected, it is showing 0.
You can see my screen, right? You can see my screen, right?
Yes.
10 addresses with each having 100 Ether.
That has gone to 0 to me. I don't know why it happened. Now again, I'm reinstalling that.
You don't require reinstall. Just open, sir. Open once again. That's it. Yeah. Okay. Yes. Any other doubts, students? Sorry, participants?
Sir, I have a doubt actually. So yes, whatever contract that we created, right? I mean, the program that we wrote, simple storage, and then we have two functions in that, right?
Yeah.
We deployed it, but then do we ever call this function also from somewhere?
Yes, possible.
Okay,
that is also possible. That means to interacting from one contract to another contract.
Okay,
that is also possible in smart contracts.
Okay, sir.
Let's see. Now, if you want, you can deploy this smart contract to a particular address also. Getting my point? Are you able to understand my question, my point here? Instead of deploying this to local blockchain, I want to deploy this smart contract to particular address. That is why you have at address is there, right? So if you specify the address here, right, this contract will be deployed to that particular address. That is also possible.
An address of MetaMask, sir?
Not MetaMask, address of contract addresses.
Contract addresses.
So would that, but then that address would belong to somebody, right?
Yes, that's what, obviously.
Mm-hmm.
If you want to deploy to that someone's address also, that is possible. That is what I mean.
Got it, sir.
Sir, now simple, sir. Now, assume that now I want to create a smart contract between the tenant and the owner. Okay. Now I am the owner, right? I have given one my house for rent. Now I'll deploy one contract specifying that all the details of the tenant. Monthly, how much he has to pay, on which date he has to pay. All these details I'll be specifying in the contract.
The rent agreement, basically. The rent agreement.
Yes, rent agreement. Right.
Yeah.
So I can deploy that contract to that my tenant's address, right?
Yes.
So this is possible, right?
Yeah.
That is what I mean.
Correct. And then just to basically authenticate that agreement, we make use of the private key.
Pardon, sir?
Basically, just to authenticate or just to prove the authenticity of that contract, the private key is used to sign that contract, right?
Yes, here we are using for that purpose, we are using MetaMask. Have you seen that?
Yes.
Once I clicked on that deploying that, automatically MetaMask was active and it is asking me to confirm which transaction fees so and so.
Got it, sir.
Only after I clicking that confirm, that right? So I am authenticating that, then automatically the transaction is stored in the blockchain.
Right. And in the real world scenario, basically when we perform the registration of the rent agreement, the same charges we pay to the registrar in the registration office. And that is
a physical contract, sir.
Yeah.
But in, this
here the metaverse is playing the same role.
Yes, but in the smart contract, right, you need not pay here for the registrar. Because,
right.
See, you can avoid that registrar concept by using smart contracts here. Because once you deploy the smart contract, that is publicly available in the blockchain, right? You cannot deny that, right? Now
yeah.
You deploy the contract saying that 10,000 rent for every month. After some amount of time, you cannot deny that you have to pay 15,000. Because the contract is available publicly, anyone can verify that.
Yes,
so you don't require registrar concept here. So
yeah,
to overcome the third party, so we are using smart contract. So once you deploy smart contract, it is automatically stored in the blockchain.
Right, sir. Got it.
Any doubts?
Sorry, sir. Now I could get that MetaMask 100 ETH is connected.
Good, sir.
To
good,
that.
Good, good, good.
So now next, what is the task I should do?
Okay, now see here, you have to come back to that Ethereum, remix.ethereum.
Okay, I come back.
Okay, so deploy, yeah. Under deploy and run transactions.
Okay.
Okay. Select the environment as injected Web3.
I am selecting. It is when I am selecting the environment as injected Web3 provider found, but it is telling some comment. Make sure your provider is active and running. When I recently activated, you may have to refresh.
I think MetaMask, you should keep that in active, sir.
It is open and it is showing 100 ETH.
I think
how do you know that MetaMask is connected, sir?
Sir, once you click on this MetaMask, right? So it will show that it is connected to Web3.
Can you
the thing is meta from MetaMask, right? Have you connected that to localhost 8545?
Yes, localhost 8545, one question mark is shown.
It is connected, right?
It is saying not connected. MetaMask is not connected to this type. To connect
button. Can you able to import address, sir?
Which address?
You imported?
Imported account for me. Import account, you are trying.
Have you got any Ether for any of your accounts?
Ether, yes, I have got it.
Then automatically it is connected. Now one thing is, so from these different accounts, right? So you should have one primary account that is connected to Ethereum. I mean Remix.
That is not connected. It is still showing not connected. And your www.profsuit.com MetaMask is not connected to this site. To connect to Web3,
you have that account address right there. Click on that.
Okay.
And you can select connected sites. So it is showing
account four. It is showing, but the connect option is not seen.
Okay, now do one thing, sir. You click on this not connected button.
Yes, I can click.
Okay, now you have the button there connect.
No, it is showing your www.trustsuit.com is not connected to Web3 site. Find the connect button on their site. What is that on there, sir? You have to go to Ganesha and somewhere I have to give?
Not Ganesh, sir. In Remix.
In Remix. In Remix, I have to give a connector.
But here, if it is a connected, automatically you have to get back this. Okay, sir. Do one thing, sir. I'll give you the step-by-step procedure. Okay. Okay. I'll provide you that. You can go through that. Okay. Step-by-step, it is clearly given.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. So, everyone understood till here? Any doubts?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Excellent explanation, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
I attended one or two courses, sir, but when I have not viewed this type of explanation.
Yeah. Thank you, sir.
Definitely, sir. Your explanation is very good. Even a layman can understand.
Yeah. Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir. That's correct. Thank you, sir.
Okay. So I'm not going for different example, but let me give one or two different examples. Wait.
Sir,
okay. Now but we
I'm
have
still facing with that Ganache is not getting downloaded in my PC. I don't understand what is the reason.
Okay, madam. At the end, you can share your screen. I'll get back to you.
Lloyd.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir.
Lloyd, if the participant, you can take break otherwise 5-10 minutes.
Okay, sir. Okay.
The participants, they want.
Okay. Shall we take break for 10 minutes?
Okay, sir. We can take a break.
Okay, sir. Fine.
Okay. Sir, can you give your email address, sir?
Sure, sir. Sure. I'll give. Definitely give. I'll paste in the chat box.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you.
Sir, I wanted to ask a question here.
Please, sir.
Actually, I am from mechanical background. I don't have any programming knowledge as such. So, okay. To get into this blockchain field, I guess what programming languages should be required or what are the prerequisites to this?
C++ or Java, sir?
C++ and Java.
Or Java.
Or Java, okay. Okay.
I have pasted my Gmail account here.
Yeah, right.
Okay, so as initially, madam gave introduction about myself, right? So I am the student of Kunwar sir, right? I was working in blockchain. I have started research in 2017, right?
Okay. I'm also doing the same.
Okay, fine. So whatever knowledge that I have gained here, whether it is cryptography or blockchain, right, I should thank my guide, Dr. Kunwar Singh, right, who has given presentation in the morning sessions, right? So all the credits goes to him because I am the new person. I have newly started research in the blockchain itself. At that time, there were no researchers in blockchain. I have started in 2017. Okay, all the credits goes to my guide, right? Based on his guidance only, today I was able to deliver this much of information, right? So this is the seventh FDP that I'm presenting past from 8 months. Okay. So all credit goes to my guide itself.
Sir, what is your background, sir? Your computer science or?
Computer science only. I'm an assistant professor in BMS College of Engineering, Bangalore.
Okay. We are a part-time scholar in NIT.
No. I was a full-time scholar through QIP.
Okay. QIP.
I have completed my 3 years and reported back to my BMS parent institution.
Okay. BMS is excellent institute.
Yeah.
Old.
Okay, during this 10 minutes of time, if anyone has any queries, they can ask me.
Sir, I'm Ramchandran.
Yes, sir.
But still that MetaMask is not getting connected.
Okay, sir. Do one thing. Okay, sir. Do one thing, sir. At the end of this session, right, we'll meet and you can share your screen.
Okay.
Right, I'll help you out. I have given the mail ID.
I'll take a break.
Yes, sir. I have given my mail ID. You can create a Google Meet. Anytime you can create, I'll help you to create that.
Okay, thank you.
Any queries?
your PhD topic, sir? What is your PhD topic, sir?
I am working in a smart contract only, sir.
Small contract for
Ethereum blockchain.
Okay.
I am working currently. I am working in vulnerabilities in smart contract.
Vulnerability. Okay. Are you publishing any papers, sir?